Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Slam of Wrestling. Myself Supreet, and this is the AEW Dynamite review for February 5th, 2020. If this is your first time on the channel, then make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on the bell for all notifications. We here in Slam of Wrestling cover all pro wrestling related stuff, including reviews for Raw, SmackDown, NXT, AEW Dynamite, and New Japan as well. So action kicks off with Jon Moxley versus Ortiz. Chris Jericho, Jake Hager, and Sammy Guevara are on commentary while Santana is at ringside. They brawl at the bell, Mox hits a clothesline and Ortiz retreats. Mox chases him back in and takes him down. He follows his knee strikes, enziguri by Ortiz, and the splash gets two. He dumps Mox and whips him to the barricade and then the steps. Back in and Ortiz works some tiger style and then a camel clutch. Mox powers out, escapes, but Ortiz hits the sit-out powerbomb for two. Mox cuts him off and transitions into a figure four, but Ortiz escapes, poking the good eye. Ortiz charges, gets dumped. Suicide dive by Mox takes out Santana and he dumps Ortiz into the crowd. Back in and Mox follows with a clothesline, a black hole slam, and that gets two. They trade, Ortiz dumps him and the suicide dive cannonball follows. Back in, Ortiz heads up top and the big splash gets two. The fisherman suplex also gets two. Ortiz grounds things, heads up top and flies into a big boot. Mox runs Ortiz into Santana. Paradigm shift finishes it and that was it. Post-match Santana attacks but gets laid out by the paradigm shift. Mox teases Jericho with the keys to the car that Jericho gifted him. He stabs Santana in the eye with them. The inner circle checks on Santana. The match was meh, but the post-match angle was good as they are still building up Jericho vs. Moxley for Revolution. SCU vs. the Best Friends. Orange Cassidy is at ringside. Trent and Cass begin locking up and working to the ropes. They work into counters. Trent follows with chops until Cass takes him down. Cass follows with more chops. They trade and Trent hits the flying knee strike. Chuck in as double team follows. Sky tags in and Chuck takes him down and then follows with a shoulder tackle. Sky follows with kicks and a drop kick. Cass back in and double team follows as Cass covers for two. Trent tags in, takes out Sky. And Cass cuts them off until Chuck hits sliced bread. Cutter by Sky and Trent then hits a spear on the floor. German by Cass on the floor. Cannonball by Chuck and everyone is down. Orange Cassidy lays down just for fun. Back in and Trent walks over Cass with chops. Chuck tags in and follows with strikes. They fight over a suplex until Chuck hits a falcon arrow for two. Trent follows with a slingshot elbow for two. Cass counters the DDT but Cass hits the backstabber. Sky tags in, dumps Chuck and double team follows on Trent for two. Trent is down, holding his neck and Chuck saves him. He clotheslines Cass and it breaks down as a soul food and a half and half combo connects. The best friends hug. Sky stops string zero and that allows Cass to hit code red for the win and that was it. A good tag team match and just the sight of Orange Cassidy made it entertaining as well. Post-match, the Dark Order attacks and lays out SCU until Orange Cassidy hits the ring. They offer him a Dark Order mask. Orange refuses and they attack. Christopher Daniels makes the save. The Dark Order refuses to attack and they leave. MJF cuts a promo on Cody, referencing the Walk Behind Her Lane from Dusty's famous promo, and says that he will whip Cody into submission and that he will never be a walk behind her again. Dr. Britt Baker vs. Yuka Sakazaki, who is not seen on AEW since Fighter Fest, and this was her Dynamite debut. Match begins, they lock up and Baker works the arm until Sakazaki counters. Baker then attacks with strikes and chokes her out. The running boot follows and the cover gets two. Sakazaki fires back, hits a runner and follows with a seated senton for two. Baker retreats. Excuse me. Baker retreats and Sakazaki follows with a high cross to the floor. back in and Sakasaki grounds things, hits a sliding clothesline, and that gets two. Baker fires back with right, they trade and Baker cuts her off with kicks and the neck breaker for two. Baker follows with the ground and pound, but Sakasaki counters lockjaw and cradles Baker for the win. Post-match, Baker lays her out with the ring bell and makes her bite the ropes before kicking the back of her head, knocking out a tooth in the process. Baker then locked in the lockjaw for good measures. The match was what it was. The post-match angle was a little strange, but Britt Baker knocking out Yuka Street looked legit. The 8-man tag team match, the Elite, Kenny Omega, Hangman Page and the Young Bucks versus the Lucha Bros, the Butcher and the Blade. Punny is at ringside. Page walks over Blade to begin. Kenny tags in and double team follows for two. Matt tags in, more double teams connect and the Elite continue to work. Quick tags. Planches follow. The heels rush the ring and take control back as Phoenix hits a huge dive to the floor, wiping out the Elite. Back in, they isolate Nick and Blade covers for two. Butcher tags in, he delivers chops, kicks and strikes. Blade back in, they work over Nick in their corner. Post commercial, Nick starts to battle back, runs the Lucha Bros into the barricades and back in. The X Factor to Blade connects. Matt tags in and follows with the rolling Northern Lights suplexes. Kenny in and Phoenix fights off Matt, takes out Kenny and follows with arm drags to both. Backstabber by Pentagon. He and Phoenix follow with double teams and isolate Kenny. Butcher tags in, lays the boots to Kenny and Blade joins in for double teams and covers for two. Butcher follows with strikes, Kenny fires back and the Rana follows. Page tags in, runs wide and follows with a plancha. Overhead belly to belly and the big moonsault on the floor. We get cowboy shit chants from the crowd. Back in and the rolling lariat gets two. The Elite corner Pentagon, but the heels drag them to the floor and isolate Nick. The Doomsday device follows for two. Powerbomb by Butcher as Kenny makes the save. The Snapdragon suplex follows. It breaks down. Butcher cuts off Page. Super kicks follow and the Elite trigger by Kenny. Blade cuts him off and the buckshot lariat by Page connects. Page is favoring his knee. He refuses to tag out and Pentagon cuts him off. The double stomp package pile driver combo connects and that got their team the victory. A great tag team match. Lucha Bros getting the pin was a great call as this sets them up to be the next challenger for their tag team titles. On the other hand, the dissension between Page and the Elite continues. Some great stuff here. Post match, Tony Schiavone arrives and interviews Kenny Omega. But before the interview even began, Pac interrupts and Pac, being the bastard that he is, still crying for a rematch. And since he says that since Omega left Nakazawa for dead, he will go after Riho. Omega quickly agrees to the match as Pac says he may be the bastard but he's not a beast. And out comes Nyla Rose attacking Riho, powerbombing her through the table. Sadly the table did break. Nyla looks at the camera and says she is coming for her championship. And I am like, why are you looking at the camera and saying that when your opponent is just near you? So Nyla gets the title shot next week and I hope Riho drops the title next week. We get a Darby Allin video package with Darby shooting a flamethrower to a Sami Chris Jericho cutout. This simply said that he is coming for revenge after last week's action. Kip Sabian vs Joey Janela. Penelope Ford is at ringside. They brawl right away with Janela taking control and choking out Sabian. Sabian fires back with kicks, strikes and they pick up the pace as he hits an enziguri. Sabian walks him over in the corner. Janela fights back with chops and running forearms as the suplex follows for two. Sabian fires back, follows with kicks, but Janela gets pissed and he delivers kicks. He dares Sabian to throw more, but Sabian locks in a chin lock. Janela escapes, they trade and Janela is cut off and tripped into the steps. Ford slams him to the steps again. Back in, Xavier covers for 2. He follows his kicks and covers for 2. Xavier takes the ref. 4 drakes Janela's eyes and they trade strikes. Until Xavier hits a suplex for 2. Xavier misses the springboard, gets dumped, and Janela follows with a suicide dive. 4 distracts him. Xavier hits a PK until Janela hits the German on the floor. Back in, Janela hits a huge lariat for 2. Xavier counters Death Valley driver, but Janela catches him with a super kick. Xavier counters back, but runs into a spiked Death Valley driver for 2. They trade until Xavier cuts him off with a DDT. Ford jumps on the apron, kisses Xavier, and Ford gets dumped to the floor, allowing Xavier to cradle Janela with the tights for the win, and that was it. This was good. I think this feud will continue and we may see this match at Revolution. In the back, Alex Marvez tries to get an interview from the inner circle. Jericho takes the mic and rants about a man who dared to take out another man's eye, running down Moxley completely. Santana takes the mic from Jericho and says he has a bad month, but Mox has unleashed something new in him and next week he is coming for Mox. An eye for an eye. The Bucks argue with Hangman Page about losing their tag team match. Mac takes his beer away to give him a reality check, but Page still has a pitcher of beer with him. Now that's some cowboy shit. Commentators run through some matches for the next 3 weeks. Rio will be defending her AEW Women's title against Nyla Rose, while Kenny Omega and Hangman Page will be defending their AEW World Tag Team titles against SCU. In 2 weeks, we'll be getting a Tag Team Battle Royal, where the winner gets a Tag Team title shot at AEW Revolution. In the same week, we'll be getting Cody vs. Wardlow in a steel cage. In 3 weeks, Kenny Omega will be facing Pac in a 30-minute Iron Man match. Final segment of the night, the 10 lashes to Cody. MJF and Wardlow arrive. Cody has to survive all 10 lashes or he doesn't get MJF at Revolution. Cody arrives, takes off his suit, his jacket and his shirt. MJF says his belt is too nice to use and demands Cody's own belt. Cody gives it to him and let the lashing begin. MJF jokes around and teases Cody for a bit and then starts whipping him. MJF hits the first shot as the Butcher, the Blade and the Bunny arrive along with other heels on the roster to watch. MJF hits another and dares Cody to hit him. MJF hits the third and Cody is welting up. Arn Anderson arrives and fires up Cody. MJF mocks Arn, hits the fourth whip and Cody is down. MJF tells Cody to quit. He refuses and wants more. The fifth shot follows and Cody drops. Dustin Rhodes arrives and wants to take the rest of the shots, but MJF refuses and tells him to bail. Dustin rallies Cody and MJF hits the sixth shot and the seventh as the Young Bucks arrive now. MJF says no one can help Cody and demands he quits. Cody tears off. MJF delivers number 8. And tells Cody to stay down. He fires up and Wardlow takes the strap, whips Cody with the number 9 and Cody drops. MJF continues talking trash as Brandi Rhodes arrives. She rallies Cody and he takes number 10. His friends check on him but MJF is not pleased, so he low blows Cody and retreats to the crowd. This segment was awesome. Cody taking 10 lashes, to be honest, was not easy to watch. Like, that really hurts. Cody did a great job selling and this really made us as a fan feel bad for him. So now the big blow up will be Cody finally getting his hands on MJF at Revolution. No doubt the best segment on the show. So that was AEW Dynamite. This week's episode was an improvement over last week's show and a great and compelling week of TV. The Cody segment was the main highlight Everything else was okay as well. We got some interesting stuff for next 3 weeks until we get to Revolution. So what did you guys think about AEW Dynamite this week? Let me know in the comment section below or on social media. You can find Slam Up Wrestling on Twitter at SlamUpW, Instagram at SlamUpWrestling. Our podcast and reviews are mainly audio based, and if you don't want your YouTube app running for that, then you can catch Slam Up Wrestling on Anchor and Spotify as well. And if you are watching on YouTube, then make sure to like this video. The like goes for this video at 10 likes, so make sure you do that, and we'll see you guys next time.